Here we are again, up on Ceres, showing you the lights up there now. Here we go. Just bear with me, everything will become clearer as we go on. And we're looking at a new concept. Cognitive science, metaphysics. There are still some people out there who will disbelieve their eyes. I mean, that's a challenge to everyone. See what is there. Changes that I could find. Trying to find something that's tangible, something that we can all understand. I mean, these first images I'm showing you here I'm getting down to the fractal zone. Yeah, I keep cropping it down and reducing it, going closer into the infinite. That's what these things are. They exist in the infinite. Fractals. Fractals are an energy. They're not self-duplicating. A lot of people in the science community will be thinking, well, they're not exactly fractals because they don't replicate. I'm not thinking that they are either. When you look at this area that I'm looking at now, these small areas, you're still looking at an image that's many miles across. Anyhow, I'm going to get back down onto the planet's surface and show you what I've found. So I've put a blue filter through this because, like I said in a previous upload, the images tend to go towards blue. Perhaps a nighttime images, aphelion images, behind the sun, as you say, the dark side. The far side of the planet. Start off with that. I always go back to black and white. There is always more to be seen inside here. You look carefully. You see the structure. Getting a bit better now. Make no mistake, these images, they're there. There's no debate here. There's nothing abstract going on. It's clear. It's clear as day. If we're following with the powers that be, and NASA, etc., these organizations, what they're telling us, they would say, people like me, it's showing you these things that's just originating in the mind. Yeah, maybe that was once upon a time. But you can see what's there. Nothing in the mind here, or the imagination. Me, the skeptics will be looking at this and don't know what to make of them. They'll be in a confused state of mind. Good. I'm not here to specifically try to change people's opinions in the skeptical community, the skeptics. Yeah, they can believe what they like. I'm not here to convince them of anything. You could say I'm here to destroy them. Yeah, that's the word. Destroy them. Yeah, that attitude of mind. These elites in society, in the science community. They're all not like that. There are some in the community, in the science community. There's many in the science community that have always believed that we're not alone in this world. And this is the evidence. Logical. I mean, you just have got to sit and think about mentally conjuring up an image. I mean, this is a conscious awakening. What you see here? Metaphysical. Look that word up. Metaphysics. Substance I'm drawing here. You can see these things. Anyhow, enough of that. I'm not trying to educate you on the sciences. I'm trying to waken you up to what you can actually see with your eyes, as opposed to what people are telling you. I say this and I keep saying it. Don't listen to anything that anybody's telling you. Look, what do you see? Yeah, I never invented these things. I just sit there and conjure up something. You can see the diagonal buildings. The structure, there's tall buildings there. It's probably high streets. I mean, I honestly believe that they're quite different to what we go through down here. They've got the same structure. See things. This, to trying to judge this on a scale is quite difficult. But I would say, or guess, that it's anything between 5 and 12 miles across and possibly a couple of miles deep, 3 miles deep. Size of a large city. Wherever I go in here, I can tease these images out of these. NASA Dawn images. Get you the same thing wherever I go. It's not he was lucky, he hit that, he's found that, see if he could find something. I've been studying these images for weeks now. I mean, I just didn't put them together yesterday. I've been looking at them, studying and thinking. And the only way for me to find out some information about them, what type of beings they are, is to look into the fractal dimension. Tells me a bit about these people, type of society it is. I mean, look, I mean, you're no silly. And if you think that NASA is going to come forward anytime soon, or anybody in government level is going to announce on the radio or the television that we're not alone, I forget that. These boys will just ignore this. Pretend it's not there, hope it goes away. I would say the colour is near enough precise to what I'm showing you here. 85% certain that I've captured the reality of this place, working the images here. The yellow filter on here. I go with the principles. We're all under the same sun. Doesn't matter where you go, whether you go to Mars, Pluto, Uranus, Venus, the Moon, all the colours are the same. They have to be, they exist under the same sun. I would imagine the skies to be the same, more especially on the Ceres. When you look at the original images, the spherical image I show you, you can see the atmosphere that's around this planet. We have to start thinking for ourselves. Out there, in the universe, are the planets out there? Are they exoplanets? Are these moons? These planetoids? Life abounds. There is no such thing as nothingness out there. Anybody that tells you differently, well, I keep saying, ignore them. These people are clowns. They're contemptible clowns. They treat you with contempt. However, they've been found out now. It's a philosophy of perception. That's what we have to see and experience and embrace it. Instead of listening to that dogmatic nonsense, that position that the academics hold. They'll not look at anything that, or tolerate anything that upsets their apple cart. Too many reputations. These people who write books and are put out there as the greatest minds, when in truth, they're just a shower of clowns. They all follow this theory that's been put up by one of their brethren. And if you go through the academic societies, the universities, teaching schools, If you decide to disagree with anything that they tell you, well, you're not going to work. You'll be ostracized. You'll be seen as a heretic. And they'll put you down, they'll ridicule you, and they'll call you a fool. Yeah. More fool them. It's about this point now, I'm going into the fractal dimension and cropping down and getting in closer, closer, and see what we come up with. Like I said, I try to study these things at this level as if I was reading or trying to read a hieroglyphic, things that you would find on a temple in Egypt or places like that. This triangular reminds me of a Buddha. I keep going in there and I can go deeper, and the deeper I go, the more detail, and it resembles fractals. However, they're dissimilar. They are similar, but they're dissimilar. They don't replicate. They've each got their own bit of space, and the energy points, these white areas, that's where the highest point of energy exists. We've got different colors. You've got the whites, you've got greens, we've got yellows and reds. And remember, this area we're looking at now resembles an eyeball. Well, your guess is as good as mine. I would imagine it to be a mile across, maybe. That's a guess. It could be 10 miles. I'm just trying to scale this out and understand what I'm looking at. There's faces inside there. Structure, design, good design. Control in this world. Everything's a lie. So naturally there has to be secrets, things that are hidden from us. The history of the First Red War. I'm trying to read into that. What I see inside that is these people that are up there, they believe in gods, sacred images. Cannot really do that when you understand that we've been told lies from the very beginning of time. All these things that constitute a belief system. Here we are again, back in the city. You see these things? But I'm looking at a reality. Boys in the science community are going to have a field day. When I first started studying these things years ago, oh, I had to go and lie in my bed to recover. Just alone with my thoughts. I didn't dare share them with anybody. People thinking you're crazy, crazy for presenting truth. Existence, objects, properties, space and time, cause and effect. Back in the city. We had to understand these things by the ancient writers, these philosophers, the tradition years ago. Plato, Aristotle, Kant. All these people that were involved in logic, social and political philosophy. Through a scientific method. I'm trying to look at here and to understand is analytical. Yeah. Always remember, what I'm showing you is there. You see these things? That's been done. You see these things?